So working. It's showing a black screen. Still showing a black screen. Wait, there it is. All right, here we are once again for the Peachbelt Conference League of Legends tournament thing. I am here on behalf of GSW Esports. I am your Tholotep. And joining me today is a friend of mine, Mr. Zachary, from...
Hello, hello.
Sorry, what are you from again? I don't remember. Middle Georgia?
I'm going to Georgia Southern right now.
You're going to Georgia Southern.
I played for Georgia College last season.
Yeah.
With Nugget Mac.
With our support. He's a cool guy.
Clay is a pretty cool guy.
Yeah. Alright, good thing we have zero viewers. Oh wait, there's one.
Columbus State's drafting a pretty scary lineup right now with the Seraphim to buff them.
You see the Udyr ban, and that was, I'm pretty sure that's what GSW was going for to begin with. Now they have to change up their plans and pick Olaf.
Columbus banning, Southwestern banning Caitlyn after the Columbus hovered it.
Yeah. Makes sense.
Galio's also
surprised they didn't ban the Veigar.
Yeah, it's one of War Nugget's go-to champions.
It is.
So wouldn't be surprised if he pulls it out here.
I know they have a diamond mid lane, so that must be why they're a bit not banning towards mid lane, if that makes sense.
And that Echo could be... Oh, it's going to be mid lane. Akram jungle.
Most likely, yeah. No, which well, would, very likely.
Not be very fun for a Veigar to play into.
Not at all. Oh, the Yumi pick.
I like the Yumi pick. It again transition from the Ezreal to the Olaf.
Yeah.
It's just
Cassidy. Well, I guess that is a good play against Echo. Or from what I've heard. Wait.
Veigar.
The last minute switch to Veigar.
No, if Southwestern can hold on to the early game, they should pretty easily outscale this team, but it's just going to be getting there. It's going to be rough.
Yep. Then there's the Vayne ADC. Well, this will be fun. Probably.
It's going to be fun for everybody except Southwestern early on. Because Olaf has three, no prio in any lane. So it's going to be pretty difficult for him to...
He has to wait to level invade. 6, really, before he pops off.
Yeah, ideally, nothing happens for Southwestern.
He might just power farm, actually.
Wait, what?
Logan, are you live?
Yes. Okay, that was interesting.
I think he was sending a link to somebody.
Yeah, he was asking if I was live.
Yeah, I don't think they want to see anybody on Columbus State for the first at least 15 minutes.
And now we wait. All right, there we go.
Something to point out is the Echo taking Halo Blades as his keystone. This game is not very typical.
He took Halo Blades? Oh.
Has to just be a mistake.
Either that or he's just onto something that we don't know.
Ms. Thomas might just be the most galaxy brain flare in the world, but I think there might be a few other things they could have taken over.
Could be.
And then up in top lane, the Darius taking Ghost. It's fine, but it should open up Krug to make some TP plays bot lane.
The Darius, oh, he took Ghost as a teleport, right?
Yep, so that's one advantage that Southwestern can get.
That also means he's probably going to focus on killing.
Yeah, that's...
He's not going to focus on any lane, he's just going to go for his dominance top lane.
And so if Krug can avoid dying,
Oh no, Krug's a just gonna very be... aggressive player.
Yeah, that Olaf could go top, but that's what the dreaded double kill by Darius is just...
Yeah.
Really scary. Don't want to go into that. And then Southwestern spot lane, having two heal summoners. It's kind of interesting.
Yep.
Those junglers getting a leash from their lanes. Gonna be pathing towards the top. Ornn getting caught out right here, walking the lane. Darius gonna pop both summoners.
Pop both flashes.
Okay. All in all, it's not that bad. He loses his flash, but hopefully Olaf can punish this somewhat. No sums, Darius.
Did he pop both the sums?
He ghosted and flashed over the wall, yeah. So. What time are you at right now in the game?
I'm at 240.
240? Okay.
Oh, there goes the cat.
Yep, Ezreal. They had double heal and just didn't use it. I guess he just didn't think that last one would kill.
Oh, wait. Relying on the tower is not a crutch. It is a talent.
That's what I was talking about, the Hailblades. If this Echo has Electrocute or Dark Harvest and...
Yeah, he would have had that.
Yeah. The Hailblades is just kind of useless.
Nope. There's a little bit of lag going on. As we hover over bot lane, nothing else going on.
Which should be good for Southwestern as they do outscale this team. They can just avoid dying and getting kills when Columbus gets aggressive like they did before in mid lane.
Oh yeah. That'll eventually be their downfall.
Looking like he's going for a kind of a cheesy kind of gank right here.
Oh, is Olaf in the bot lane? He is in the bot lane. Saw that Hecarim was about to go in. He's getting Gromp right now. But Olaf is on Dragon, so there could be a little contestion in that. Contest in it.
Prog just solo kills
Darius.
Solo kills Darius, that's not where you want to be as a Darius player top lane. Yep.
Wasn't watching that part. Oh, he did. Interesting. It's not something you expect. Especially not at level 5 and 4.
Blue team getting Dragon early like this is...
And Hecarim is counter-jungling.
Not what's supposed to be happening for Columbus right now. They should be taking both Dragons early. Getting like the first two.
Yeah. Seems that Ornn is bullying Darius out of lane. We're getting various pings at the Scuttle Crab too. I wonder who that is.
And
oh.
Olaf is pausing it.
Huge.
It's very important.
It is. She can hear our beautiful voices. And there's the ready from both teams. And the game has been unpaused.
So there's still a slight gold lead for the red team, but their blue team still has a dragon advantage.
That gold lead is all in the jungle. Or mostly.
Yeah, the CS difference in jungle. But it's kind of made up by the bot lane, and Darius is going to get away. Olaf is here, though.
Olaf is here, too. It's a 2v2 now instead of a 2v1.
Krug. Just flashing on the guy to kill him.
Using everything he has, basically. and Mr. Leprechaun Veigar getting out of there with barely any scratch.
Krug has been top gapping the past two games for Southwestern.
Yeah. He's quite good at it.
Even here in a bad matchup for him, he's able to get a 2-kill advantage.
Especially in laning phase. Ornn against Darius, 2-kill advantage is amazing.
Yeah, these lanes are not playing out how they're supposed to. Definitely not the Olaf solo killing the Darius. And at this point, he's just so tanky, he can't. There's nothing Darius can do anymore.
We see that both Hecarim and Echo are collapsing in just for top lane.
And there's no TP for Veigar, so this is going to be a 2v3.
Yep, seems like Echo and Hecarim couldn't make it just fast enough. But it does seem that Olaf is going to go for Rift Herald. But it looks like he sighted Echo instead. Decided to move off.
And this is the issue with taking Ghost Darius top lane. If you
have
don't
no
get
pressure
ahead,
on other lanes.
You're useless. He tried for the kill level 1, didn't get it, and he's paying for it now.
Dragon be up in 30 seconds. It's like red team is gonna camp that area. And Ornn has his teleport up. This will become a 5 versus 4, man. 5v4.
Should start this on cooldown after taking the red buff. And like you said, Ornn can TP bottom, turn into a 5v4, and swing it in towards the Southwestern's favor.
Indeed.
Columbus does have the river warded up and their own jungle, so there's not really any opportunity for any kind of flank
ward.
Now
is the time for getting Dragon, though, now that Hecarim is closer to top lane. Actually, it looks like he's going to get Rift Herald.
Olaf is looking for a gank, but he could just be doing Dragon right now.
Hecarim is on Rift Herald. Early Rift Herald is easy to give up, isn't it?
For the Southwestern is very comfortable with this trade. Dragon for Herald, Notion Dragon at that. It's going to be an Air Drake as a soul.
Windrake, that's pretty big for Olaf.
Yeah, once he ults it, if he gets to the move speed when they get Sol,
yep.
It's just with the Yumi attached to him, he can't stop him.
There's no stopping him, not even Hecarim.
He's quite literally unstoppable. It's going to spot Olaf bottom, which means Hecarim's probably going to invade and take his blue side.
After he gets Skullcrab, that is.
Heck, I'm ulting just to get out of the cage.
Yeah, you didn't want to be farm for the Veigar.
Which at this point is almost a 2 minute cooldown. Minute and a half.
Hecarim's ult?
Yeah, so that keeps mid pretty safe for right now. Krug beating up on this Darius again.
Really bullying him practically. They're both going in on him.
And
they're gonna get it too.
This should be top tower. First tower for Georgia Southwestern.
Indeed.
Hecarim's looking mid. Just gonna take some raptors away from.
He's gonna steal the chickens, indeed. And probably, he's probably gonna try to pinch up a Veigar too. The old, the good old, what is it called? One taxi from the back, one taxi from the front. Pincer method.
They probably could have dove him, but like I said, he doesn't have ult, so it's just too hard to make a tower dive work.
Oh, and he doesn't have flash either. He picked ghost instead.
Olaf's Hecarim's going through
Hecarim
the tower.
Hecarim is bot lane. Yep.
Olaf is. Yeah, it's Veigar TP actually. It's a double
Ornn
TP.
Ornn TPing in. Veigar TPing in. This is a full 3v3, 3v4. 4v2.
And it's kind of good.
It's kind of an early ult from Ornn too. Darius really focused on the split bush, that is.
I mean, yeah, he's useless now. The game's pretty much over for Darius.
All he can do is push the turrets.
I have third dragon spawning right now. Ornn does have all for this, so this should just go to Southwestern.
Third dragon. And now GSW has a lead in gold, too.
Yeah, this Echo pick. For Columbus State, it's just not working out. Neither is the Darius.
Not at all. It seems that Echo has been really avoiding the cage more than anything. The threat of that ability is quite high for him.
His Echo will be going to a side lane now, though. That's in this long lane he can. Potentially pick off the Veigar.
Yep. Very last pixel. Echo is in the bush waiting for the Veigar. Yep, there he is.
And as soon as Echo goes for that Grug, DCs.
MediaCom, baby. Yep. That is quite the scene to see right there.
Just see Veigar's life flashing before his eyes and the pause comes through.
I love the part in the chat where it says, "Yo, Flash, I have backup." All right, they're back.
And Nugget's just gonna get out of it.
Yeah, he just realized that he just wasn't in the range.
It's very unlucky for Ekat. The pause actually just came at a terrible time for him.
It really did.
The nature of it, I guess.
It's the nature of MediaCom.
Well, that's going to start up the Herald.
Mm-hmm.
Has about 1 minute to take it. It'll despawn about 1950.
Baron is about to spawn in too.
We have Cloud Soul spawning already at 21 minutes in this game, so.
Indeed.
It'll probably be when we get our next fight.
Red team will probably try to play really aggressive when that Cloud Drake spawns in, just to keep the blue team from getting the soul.
Yeah, the win con for Columbus State is just turned into how Southwestern's winning the game through Dragons. They're about to pick up their soul here in a minute. Minute and a half.
Seems like they're all... They're planning to be there earlier, clearing wards.
Maybe pick off the Veigar right now.
Nope, just push the Veigar under tower.
Result.
Hecarim saved Veigar right there.
He failed his ult over this wall. He tried to go over it and didn't actually clear it. That little piece in the wall. He ghosted as well, which means he's not going to have that for the fight, a dragon. And even if he killed the Veigar, he would have just TP'd back for the dragon. So, like, I don't... It's a little over-aggressive for him to be going for that.
Echo's purchase a stopwatch. That'll come in handy this next team fight.
Yeah, they know that.
Especially
this is
if he's focused
the
by the Veigar.
There he is backing as well, so I can try to get to this. Yumi also has her Moonstone, whereas Seraphine does not, so Yumi's going to be putting out a bunch of heals for her team.
Echo's behind the lines.
Behind the team.
Yep.
Seraphine's getting picked off here, though.
Yep. Now it's a 4v5 no matter what. She won't be back up in time.
Vigar's getting pulled by Darius. Ornald's going
Ornald's
to hit Vayne.
Ornald's going to hit them anyways, even after the flash. Now it's a 3v5. And Rift Herald's being placed mid lane.
Everything's just falling apart for Columbus Day right now.
Mm-hmm.
Just getting picked off one at a time. They're going to lose Cloud Soul as well.
Yumi's going to jump on the Ornn, give him a little quick heal. While the rest of the team goes and gets Soul.
Krug has just got to the point where they just don't do damage to him anymore.
He's
and
unstoppable,
then
basically.
And he's just actually unkillable.
Even Yumi's heal was like a drop of water in a lake.
I'd like to see the Ornn go bottom though, since the Ornn has TP and you could put Ezreal top lane, or top or mid, with the Veigar in the other lane.
That was cool.
Now that Baron's the only objective to take.
What just did 1,000 true damage to that, Scuttler?
The stun. It breaks the, shield.
Alright.
The low gray health, the shield, if it gets, the Scuttle gets CC'd, it breaks it.
Oh, that makes sense.
I think it ran into the Veigar cage. I think that's what happened, at least. Olaf and Yumi could maybe tank the Baron, but kind of risky.
I mean, probably wouldn't be the first time somebody did that.
Oof, Echo's gonna blink over the cage. Viger's just gonna walk out.
Yep.
Seems like Southwestern's just content farming it out until Elder Dragon spawns. Not really looking to fight this team.
Yep.
First Ornn item's coming in too. He's upgrading Olaf's Gore Drinker.
That works. A lot, actually. So
that's the other benefit of having
boon.
A horn.
One could say.
So we had the Elder Dragon spawning in 2 minutes, and that's really when Columbus A is just going to be forced to fight them. They're going to look to not get picked off like they did last time, but I mean, it's hard with this Olaf just running at you right now.
Yep.
On top of the Ornal and Yumi ult.
Mr. Ornn's clear is quite amazing right now. You can practically destroy a minion wave in seconds.
And this Echo is, I mean, everybody's just terrified of this Ornn right now. Cannot fight him. I want to see if Ornn can get to level 15 before this dragon fight so he can upgrade one of Vygar Ezreal's items.
They're going for Baron, currently.
Gonna start the Baron.
They're gonna try to kill Baron, then possibly move right on directly to Elder Drake.
Which just feels a little forced. You're gonna group up right for the Hecarim ult into the Baron pit. On top of the Echo stun.
Yep, there's the Baron ult. There's the...
And the Hecarim stun.
Smite!
Yep. Which, the fight's still looking winnable for Southwestern. Vygar was able to kill
still
off the Echo
out.
After Echo killed the Ezreal.
One kill for two deaths.
Even though Hecarim did steal the Baron for Columbus State, they are going to be able to take the Elder Dragon here. With no jungler, it's just free for Olaf to take this time.
Yep, and... Yep, their jungler is dead. And Olaf still has his flash. Smite. And now they all have executioners, basically.
And so, yeah, that's what I was talking about. It was a bit of a forced Baron. They could have waited for the Elder to spawn, take the Elder. And
maybe they're trying to force a team fight using the Baron.
Try to turn on them.
Which worked.
In the end, they're too far ahead, Georgia Southwestern, to really make a difference for Columbus. They stole the Baron, it just didn't end up mattering. Taking the Baron does give 300 gold to each member on Columbus State and narrows the gold gap a little bit, but it's still a 3,000 gold lead for Georgia Southwestern.
Yep. See that they're aiming for towers now.
Yeah, so even though Columbus took the Baron, they really can't push.
They
due
can't
to
really
the fact
do much
that
with
they
it.
Have Elder. In any fight that Georgia Southwestern takes right now, they're just going to win. Look like they tried to go after the Ornn top lane with the Echo and Darius, but he's just again reached the point where he can't touch him. And
Seraphine just couldn't make it out alive. And
Echo is gonna die to the Ornn ult.
Yuumi just killed Vayne. Now it's been an ace.
And that's gonna be game for Southwestern.
Most likely.
This Krug really put the team on his back again.
He did.
Giving time for the Veigar and the Ezreal scale.
There's the DGWPs in the chat.
It's game one.
Game one is over. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, due to various issues with Discord, it seems that I will be the sole caster this time around for the second game. So, bear with me, bear with my voice. It will be a ride. So, I just got kicked out of the spectating mode, and it won't let me rejoin, so I might have to cut this stream a little bit soon. It has kicked me out of League 2. Interesting. Alright, actually, I've just gotten back in. Let us see if it works. Here we go. Yep, it seems like MediaCom is stricken again. Especially for those two. So once again, we are back. We didn't miss too much, it seems. No one gets a kill for that one. like Krog 1 will not get the solo kill top lane this time. That is what Kassadin does. He uses his ult to get under tower, kill you immediately, then leave. First tower goes to GSW. Not first tower, my bad. First dragon. It's 3v2 mid lane. Quite an interesting combination. Hecarim gets killed off. Roosterbuck also kills Hecarim. Roosterbuck barely makes it away as Lee Sin. And the ADC comes in to pick off the mid laner. Quite a successful gank, I could say. Here comes the Roosterbuck, trying to help out Krug. And it seems that the Crocodile gets out of this instance alive. Comes Lee Sin, the gank, preoccupied by the red ward, pink ward. And Kassadin gets the kill on Veigar. Seems that Cho'Gath just can't win this trade. There he goes, Aphelios. Seems that red team is getting the second dragon. Yep. It's Mountain Soul this time. Gives him a shield. And I think a little bit of extra health. Not really a useful dragon soul, but it's quite nice to have. And they placed the first Herald down mid lane. Steal a few plates. Get that extra gold. Seems that Mr. Cho'Gath thinks he can win this trade now. Until he's stunned, walks away. Kicks him back under tower. And gets the kill. Effectively avenging the top laner. Hecarim is also about to gank top on Lee Sin. Lee Sin chooses dip instead. Chooses to leave. Or continue farming, actually. Seems that Cho'Gath has regained some of his confidence so he can continue trading with the Renekton. 3v2 bot lane. The gank from the jungler. It's really a bad matchup for Vhagar. And then there's a teleport from also Vhagar to help the top laner. He ults the Renekton. Renekton gets away just a hair pin of health. Three dragons for the red team. A nice combo from the Lee Sin. Immediately killing off Lulu. Seems that top lane and mid lane have traded. Akram is coming in for the gank on the Vhagar. Make sure they get Akram too. But Akram was ulted by Lulu, giving him tons of health. Damage. How will he make it out of this alive? He won't. That's the answer, he won't. And then they continue counter-taking the red buff from Lee Sin. There goes the jungler, the one that is needed for this play. Blue team just going in. Power dynamic has completely changed compared to last game. Red team is just not giving up. Yep, there's the Cho'Gath ult to steal. Quite unnecessary by the Veigar. But he went for it anyways. And 24 minutes in, red team has Dragon Soul. Now it's a 3v2 top lane. Now it's a 3v1. I don't think Krug1 can make it out of this. Seems that Phileas just missed his ult too. As it is now a 5 person. Going on to Baron. Let's see what happens here. Quite unfortunate for red team, that is. Quite a level difference right there too, 14 versus 17. Yep, even with that level difference, Cho'Gath is still huge. You're not gonna let blue team have this Elder Drake, it seems. Seems our red team is also going to go for Baron buff. There's the Cho'Gath. second mid-second tier turret has been taken. The split push from Cho'Gath is practically unnoticed. Nope, Cho'Gath seems to die here. Yep. I think this is where they end the game. Yep, this is where red team ends the game. There's the GGWPs in chat. And GSW has once again won their position. Thank you for sticking with me for this game. It's quite appreciated. So once again, have a good day. And see you later. See you next week.